fictitious assets. As the name suggests, these are not assets in a true sense. These generally include some one-time heavy expenses which are not considered as an expense only in the year in which they are incurred. Rather, these expenses are shown as expenses over a few accounting years. If the entire amount of such expenses is considered as an expense in the year of the occurrence of the expenses, these expenses may result in a big loss in that particular year. So these expenses are spread out over a few years. For example, preliminary expenses. Preliminary expenses are the expenses incurred at the time of starting the business. If the entire amount of preliminary expenses is assigned to the first year only, it would result in a huge loss in the first year itself. So instead of treating the entire amount of preliminary expenses as an expense for the first year, these expenses would be spread out over a few accounting years. For example, say preliminary expenses are rupees 100. So what the firm may do is spread this preliminary expense over a period of say 5 years. So in the first year only rupees 20 would be considered as preliminary expenses. Rupees 20 is derived, this figure is derived by dividing rupees 100 by 5. So in the first year only rupees 20 would be considered as preliminary expenses and the balance 80 would be shown as an asset in the first year. This rupees 80 which would be shown as an asset is an example of fictitious asset. So there will be a fictitious asset of rupees 80 which will be shown in the asset side of the first year. During the second year again rupees 20 will be considered as preliminary expenses and the balance of rupees 60 would be shown as an asset in the second year, so on and so forth. This rupees 60 which would be shown in the balance sheet of the second year as an asset is also an example of fictitious asset. Thus, such expenses are spread out over a period of accounting years.